I want to be just like you. I figure all I need's a lobotomy and some tights.
This is from Miracle-Gro. It's organic potting mix, and it has all kinds of good stuff in it. It's organic, blah, 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 you know what I mean. So they normally sell this for around, I don't know, 8 to 12 bucks, and I got them for $5 a bag. And it's end-of-season stuff, so they're just getting rid of it. And this is moisture control potting mix. It's not organic, but it's fantastic stuff. It is amazing stuff. And, you know, it's just a couple bucks. And things like bulbs. These are hyacinth bulbs. Hyacinth is my favorite bulb flower. I don't know why. I think it's because of the smell. I love the smell. So I got, like, tons of different colored hyacinth. Tulips, white tulips, red tulips. I like tulips because they remind me of when I was a kid. There was this old lady that always grew tulips in front of her house. And I don't know why. They didn't have the weird mixes back then, you know, like multicolored tulips and stuff. They just had like the old-fashioned kind. And for some reason, they seem to smell, you know, have smell to them. Nowadays, you really can't find them with a lot of smell in them. Because I guess the hybrids go more for looks than smell. So I got all of these, you know, like a buck or two a bag, and normally they cost a heck of a lot more. They're just getting rid of them at the grocery stores, hardware stores, gardening centers, things like that. So I grow a lot of, I'm going to be growing a lot of bulbs inside this winter, and I'm going to have hyacinth sprouting up all over the place. And if everything works good, as soon as the flowers are gone, the greens will form more bulbs underneath, and I'll have bulbs for the spring. So it's a good thing. I'm going to grow these this winter. And it doesn't have to be organic. I mean, it's not like I'm eating these things, so what do I care? And it's also hard on organic gardeners to bring in compost inside to grow stuff during the winter because, you know, there may be bugs in it. It's kind of a pain in the butt. Even for me, it's hard to get enough organic stuff in the house to grow as much as I want to grow during the winter. So I kind of do a compromise. In the wintertime, if I'm going to be eating something like a tomato, I try to make it as organic as possible, and I don't think I've ever grown it non-organic inside because I don't want to put my tomato plant in chemicals and eat the food. That's just me, okay? Other people don't have a problem with it. I don't have a problem with them. Whatever you like to do is totally cool. As long as you're growing something, that's really all that matters, right? And so what I do and what I'm going to do this winter is I'm going to mix it up. I'm going to do all kinds of strange stuff. And I have organic potting mix. I have non-organic. I have more than just this. I have two big bags of this. And I'm going to be growing stuff in that. The reason I like this is because it has moisture control. And I couldn't find moisture control in the organic. The moisture control stuff in whatever this stuff is, it does wonderful. I mean, when you water it, it stays light and loose and just beautiful. So I'm going to mix this with the organic, grow some of these in it. And for like my tomatoes and lettuce and things like that, I'm going to use pure organic and pure compost. So I have some compost in here. This is a compost that I made myself. So I have a lot of everything going on in here. And I just wanted to let you guys know that whatever you decide to do, don't feel bad about not going organic or just going organic and not being able to do it in the wintertime. Whatever you got to do to make yourself happy and to grow stuff, that's perfectly cool. Just do it. All right? So if you're on a budget, and a lot of us are right now, even me, if you're on a budget, end of season is the best time to buy anything gardening, garden tools, garden soil, things like that. You can take this, toss it in your basement, and use it next spring if you want. It's going to last. It's not going to go bad. I mean, come on, it's soil. And even if it gets a little moldy, who cares? It isn't going to hurt anything. It never hurt me, and I've been doing this for years. This is nothing new. It's just something new I did a video on. And I've been doing this for years. End of season, I always go to the stores, and nobody's interested in garden stuff, so I got the whole section to myself. And I go shopping with my big shopping cart and just start tossing stuff in there. And I get an excellent deal out of that. And I store it in my basement. So a lot of this stuff is from last year, and not this, but the stuff that I use inside. And as far as the compost, I bring in compost because this sort of stuff only feeds for a couple months. I mean, it has whatever it has in it, and it doesn't feed for very long, even especially the non-organic stuff. That feeds for a couple months. That's not long enough for me. I mean, come on, I'm in Minnesota. My winters last at least 11 out of 12 months of the year. It seems like that. This is a better growing medium than pure compost, But compost has better food in it, so I mix them together and I get a really nice combination. So some of the stuff I'm going to be growing this winter is non-organic, some of it's organic, some of it's going to be what I like to call my Frankenstein mix, because I have organic potting mix, I have non-organic potting mix that holds in the moisture, I have my compost, which is the food that's going to fuel all of this, and then I have a new addition, my rock mineral dust. So I'm going to be making this Frankenstein potting soil mix, and I think I'm going to do pretty good this winter. I think I'm going to have a fantastic indoor garden. I'm going to be growing all kinds of things, you know, like onions, lettuce. I have all kinds of seeds from the garden. I'm going to grow tomatoes. I have over here, I don't know if you guys can see it, I poked myself. I dug up my rose bush because I thought, you know, if I move next spring, I don't want to leave my rose bush. I spent years developing this rose bush. It has a real sturdy stalk on the bottom of it and a great root system. So I dug it up, rinsed all the dirt off of it, brought it inside. Same thing with my grapevines. Remember you saw the grapevines, maybe a couple shots in the garden? I dug those out by the roots and I brought them inside, and it's got a nice thick root, and I toss it in a bucket of water until I could get this ready. So I'm going to plant them, grow them inside. I'm going to have grapevines in my house this winter, and a rose bush. Hopefully it'll put out leaves, and maybe I'll even get roses in my house this winter. It does not have to cost you a lot to garden inside or even outside. Whatever you have to do to get something growing, that's all it takes. You don't have to have a garden like mine. You don't have to have raised beds. You don't have to have everything perfect, as long as you're growing it, you know? And hold on, I'm going to show you something. This right here is kind of a mess, and you would think, oh, Mr. Tomato probably has perfect looking tomatoes. I do not. And here's an example. This one was growing inside. It's my cherry tomato, and I didn't want to throw it out, so I left it inside all season, kept cutting it back. It grew up, I cut it back, and I got a tomato. One tomato on this entire plant, and it's growing in compost, and it just hasn't been getting enough light. There wasn't enough room in my windows. But this is an example of what I try and tell you is, grow anything. Even if you get one tomato, so what? It's your tomato, and it's going to taste wonderful. One tomato is going to taste fantastic because I grew it myself, and it's growing inside in the winter, and it's not store-bought, so I'm going to love this. Grow whatever you can. It's yours, and it's a fun thing to do, and it's something great to look at in the wintertime, you know, when it's cold outside and nothing's going on out in the garden. You got something in your window, one plant, 10 plants, 1,000 plants, it doesn't matter. A grow light, whatever you got to do, get it growing. And if you have any questions, if I can help you guys at all, let me know, okay? Okay, I got things to do. Oh, here's another thing. Remember the shallots I was growing? Yeah, I collected them, braided the stems, dried them out, and I'm going to be growing these. They're wrapped in a paper towel to keep them kind of dry. But I'm going to be growing shallots in my window this winter, so I'll have shallot greens for cooking, and the shallots will form extra bulbs, and hopefully if I time it right, the shallot bulbs will be ready by next spring, and I won't have to buy these to plant them. I'll actually have my own shallot bulbs. So that's the plan. Whatever you got that you can grow, knock yourself out and get it growing, okay? I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy. Bye.